Hello everyone, this is an update about my project which builds a Bluetooth adapter for these Palm portable keyboards. Just a recap, these keyboards were built for Palm PDAs. They can fold and unfold like this. They were previously only meant for Palm PDAs, but I built an adapter which transformed them into a Bluetooth keyboard. Now, after I posted my first video, I got a lot of feedback, and now I have a second version of this keyboard. So, what has changed? The most important part is I used a different SoC or microcontroller for the motherboard. It was previously an NRF chipset, which is, this is the first one, which is power efficient, but it's very expensive, and you need the extra component for soldering. This one is based on ESP32C3. It is slightly more power hungry, but it's very cheap, and you don't need extra components like resistors to make this. So that makes this way easier to build and way cheaper to build. To compensate on the power consumption of the new chip, I had to use a larger lithium battery, but as you can see, the final product is not significantly larger, so it's still acceptable. Another update is now this adapter supports three types of keyboards. I have added support for the handspring visor connector, which is like this. And I also improved the compatibility of the Palm 3 connector. Apparently, there were two versions of the Palm 3 keyboards. One version, the connector can be propped up, the others cannot. So I redesigned the connector here to be compatible with both. That is another update. Now, a lot of you have asked whether I can add support for the Palm Universal connector, which is like this. It is a connector for M505 and above. I have been trying to do this, but the pins are very small. I couldn't find a reliable way to replicate the connector. So yeah, for now it is still not supported. Now let's take a look at the inside of this version 2 adapter. It is based on a off-the-shelf motherboard from LilyGo. You can buy it from AliExpress. As you can see, I don't have to solder any additional transistors. All you need to do is to solder wires to the GPIOs, and it directly goes to the connector. You do need to fly a wire if you want to repurpose this red LED, but otherwise it's pretty simple to solder. And just like the previous version, it has a small switch embedded in the connector part. Once you plug this into the keyboard, it will turn the board on, and once you unplug it, it will turn it off, so it doesn't have a lot of power consumption. Let's have a demo to see how these connectors connect to the keyboards. I'm going to start with the Palm 3 keyboard here. All I have to do is lay it flat. The connector goes in like this. And once this is initialized, the green LED will start flashing. And now you can search for this keyboard on your phone or computer through Bluetooth. And it is discovered with the name of Palm keyboard. Simply pair that and it is ready to go. Let's open a text box and start typing. Yeah, it is that simple. And once you are done, you can simply unplug the adapter and fold it. And yeah, the Bluetooth will automatically disconnect. Now the Pump 5 is similar, except you would need to pull the kickstand out a little bit before trying to put this in. This connector goes in flat and you insert like this direction. And just like that, it will start pairing mode. You can see it stays on the keyboard like this. Yeah, it's pretty simple. The handspring visor. This one, you will need to pull the kickstand out a little bit. And the adapter goes in like 45 degrees. You would first insert this feet into this hole, and then try to insert that feet into that hole. Just like that. Okay, that's it for the update. I have uploaded the steps to make these adapters to GitHub. The link is in the video description. So if you are interested, you can follow that tutorial to build one yourself. I have also built a small batch of the adapters for sale. The link is also in the video description. But I cannot guarantee I will keep doing that in the long term. So yeah, please check out the GitHub if you really want to build it yourself. That is all. Thanks very much for watching. Hope this video helps.